A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 24th April, on the front page you have Sri Lanka links Easter blast to Christchurch mosque attacks. So this is regarding the serial blasts on Easter Sunday in Sri Lanka, and over 320 people were killed. Now it is said that it is linked to the Christchurch mosque shootings in New Zealand, which happened on March 15. So this is what the Minister of State for Defence of Sri Lanka told the Parliament. So based on initial evidence, this link is being made. Then, this is judges panel to hear charges against CJI. So this is regarding the sexual harassment or sexual charges against the Chief Justice of India. So judges panel is going to hear these charges. And this is India may stop oil imports from Iran. So post USA clearly stating that the exemption which has been provided to a few countries, including India, to 8 countries, including India, will not be extended after May 2019. So India has said that it may stop oil imports from Iran now. On page 7 you have Vice Admiral Verma moves tribunal. So Vice Admiral Bimal Verma has once again moved a military tribunal challenging the appointment of Vice Admiral Karambir Singh as the next Chief of Naval Staff after the Defence Ministry did not respond to a statutory complaint. So this is regarding appointments in Navy. So it's an important issue. And this is price controls hurting FDI in medical devices. So industry sources blame dip in funding coming for medical devices on the government curbs and limits which have been imposed on prices of medical devices. On the editorial page, the first editorial is in an oil slick. So this is regarding US, the front page news yesterday that US said it would not extend the May 2 deadline for imposing sanctions on, you know, on transactions with Iran, so oil imports from Iran to be specific. So India is has been given exemption by USA, but that exemption ends on May 2. So India is actually testing its traditional ties with Iran too by giving in to US bullying. So this is the crisis which, you know, or dilemma which India is facing. And this is the halfway mark. So this says that with a month to counting day, when the counting will take place, BJP has upped the Hindutva pitch in the Hindi heartland. So last time BJP fought on the plank of development, this time it is Hindutva. Then the lead article is the permanence of Arab uprisings. So this is that as protests hit Sudan and Algeria, it is anybody's guess if they will go the Tunisia or Egypt way. So such Arab Springs uprisings have been seen in various countries. Now Sudan and Algeria are also under crisis, and what the future holds for them can be seen from what happened in Tunisia and Egypt too. Even here we have seen how resistance is being given to, you know, to the military taking over. Then this is the problem with cherry picking data. So this says that if it's the government's case that NSSO figures are suspect, what has its based policy decisions on? So we have seen how data has been used the way it is convenient for the government. So that point is highlighted in this article. Then on op-ed page you have India's perilous obsession with Pakistan. So it says the hyper-nationalistic frenzy to defeat Pakistan comes with a huge human and material cost. So that is the point which is highlighted in this article. And below you have outer space lessons. So it says in furthering its outer space ambitions, India must study the experiences of other space powers. So when we are getting into outer space, steps being taken by us, what are the experiences of other countries, other space powers like US, Russia is to be studied too. And here there's one more article regarding India-Australia security relations. So deepening them must be seen against the backdrop of expanding bilateral ties. So deepening India-Australia security relations is covered here. Then on international page you have here Kim to meet Putin in Vladivostok this week. So this is North Korean leader Kim Jong-un who would meet Russian President Vladimir Putin in Russia's Pacific port Vladivostok to discuss the international standoff over North Korea's nuclear program. Then on business page you have RBI swap auction gets bids more than thrice the notified amount. So RBI had announced 25,000 crore bond purchases. So liquidity deficit is at over 1 lakh crore rupees. So it wanted to infuse this liquidity in the economy. So 25,000 crores bond purchases was proposed. So when RBI purchases bonds, money would be infused in the economy. But this RBI second dollar RBI swap auction also saw very healthy demand, with RBI getting 255 bids worth $18.65 billion compared with the notified amount of $5 billion. Then this is Procter & Gamble India guilty of not passing on GST rate cut. So this is the Directorate General of Anti-Profiteering under GST Act, which has found the firm profited by 250 crore rupees. So it will take action against the firm for not passing on the benefits of GST rate cut to consumers. Below you have shipping firms seek PM's help to stay afloat. So shipping firms are in a crisis. They seek scrapping of circular and the notification taking away their right of first refusal. So foreign flag vessels built in India but not owned by Indian firms are being preferred over those under Indian flag. So the notification which took away the right of first refusal from the Indian firms need to be scrapped is what the shipping firms are asking the government for. Also, you should understand the benefit of covering current affairs over a year. So what is in news right now is not a new issue. It has been in news for over a year and a year back too. So you will come to know if you have looked at the current affairs keywords initiative for prelims 2019 on our website. So here we have covered up current affairs for over the year. So various sections. So in geography section here you can see the keywords covered. On second page, you have this right of first refusal issue. So here you can see this. It talks of national fleet policy, which came in at that time. What is cabotage? What is right of first refusal? And how India relaxed cabotage laws in May 2018. So all that is covered here. So the coverage there would have given you a clear understanding. So that is there. And there is sports coverage on the last page too. So that is it. And also for current affairs, detailed PDF videos are uploaded on the website every day by the end of the day. So you can download these PDF files here too. So the detailed coverage of current affairs which is covered is provided here. That is it. Thank you.